Hello students, now we will move on to our next topic, analysis of variance. This is the last topic. So here we will study what is F test, and this topic is actually we are going to study about the distribution of sample variance and distribution of ratio of variance obtained from two samples. Okay, then suppose you want to test whether a random sample x1, x2, etc., xn, you are given a set of samples x1, etc., x2, etc., xn, and this is been drawn from a normal population with mean mu and standard deviation sigma, or variance you can say sigma square. Then we define there a chi square with the formula xi minus x bar the whole square divided by sigma square. So this is a chi square, means x1, x2, etc., xn follows a chi square with mean mu and variance sigma square, and this chi square will be having n minus 1 degrees of freedom. Okay, then now here in F test what we do is, here we are going to test equivalence of variance, that is sigma 1 square equal to sigma 2 square. We are going to check this one, that is testing of hypothesis about equality of two variances using F distribution. Okay, now suppose you are given a random variable x which follows a chi square distribution with n1 degrees of freedom, and y is another variate that also follows a chi square with n2 degrees of freedom, then we define x is equal to x by y. So this also will follow, and this follows, means x follows a chi square, y follows a chi square, then f equal to x by y follows an F distribution with degrees of freedom n1, n2. Okay, so this is a basic concept of F distribution, that is two chi square distribution, two chi square variate are there, then when you consider its ratio, that follows an F distribution with n1, n2 degrees of freedom. Okay, now this is the almost shape of a chi, of an F distribution is like this. Here I have marked these two points, these two shaded part. This is two tailed F test. Okay, when it is only one tail, only one tail means either right or left tail, you will consider only the one part, this part only you will consider. And if it is left tailed, so this shaded portion, this shaded portion will be the region of rejection. And if you consider a right tail, region of rejection is the right shaded part. And if you consider a two tail F test, region of rejection will be these two parts. So like in all the previous one, if alpha equal to level of significance is say 10%, in a two-tail test, this will be 5% each. So if alpha equal to 10, then this will be alpha by 2 part, this will be alpha by 2 part. These two regions will be the region of rejection in a two-tail test. In a single-tail test, when you say alpha equal to 10%, that means it is either to the right side of this or to the left side of this, depending on which tail test we consider. Okay, so whenever you are given this alpha, if you are considering a two tail test, you will take half of that only to find the value from the tables. Okay, now I'll tell you, just tell you how to take the table value. Now suppose I want to calculate value of F, say here n1 n2. So F 10, 8 I want to calculate. Okay, degrees of freedom is given like this. F 10, 8, say at 5%. Alpha is 10, so I am considering a two-tail test. So at 5%, how I will take the table value. So this will be 5% means 0.05. So there is another table called as F table. This is already given to you in your Google Classroom. I have a small sheet with me. I'll just show you this one. So please see whether it is visible or not. So here, this is an F distribution table. Here you can see, here on this top part, here some numbers are here, and here also 1, 2, 3 like that numbers are there. Okay, so these are the degrees of freedom. So degrees of freedom is given. The right part will be degrees of freedom for the numerator, because later you will come to know why numerator denominator. So right part is the degrees of freedom of the numerator, and left part is degrees of freedom of the denominator. So when I write here f 10 8, this 10 is the degrees of freedom of the numerator part, and 8 is the degrees of freedom of the denominator part. So at 5% means 0.05. so in the table it will be given there of which percentage it is, 5%, 10%, whatever it is. This is for 5% means 0.05. so you need to look at the table. Now f 10 8 I have to calculate, so I will go for f 10 here. This is f 10, correspondingly 8 value here from the left. 8 value here, 8 is here, 10 8. So we say f 10 8, so 10 numerator, 8 denominator. So this is 10, 8 value is 3.34 you will get here. Okay, the table which you have with you is a simple table, so it's very easy to understand from that one. So here two tables are given simultaneously, two level of significance table is given in one table. So here the one you are having, it is simple one only, level of significance of alpha equal to 5%, 10% is given there. So here f 10 8 means first number you will look at this top here, and second number you will look at here, corresponding value you will look at the table. Okay, so that is the table values. So that table values shows that suppose 3.34 is here, suppose 3.34 I am getting here. So that 3.34 means area after this 3.34 is 0.05, because I have found out this one with respect to alpha is 5. So area right to that particular value is 3, whatever that value is, 3.34 3.63, whatever, as per the degrees of freedom and as per alpha it will change. So the rejection region lies in that part. Okay, so now I'll tell you how to calculate using, or how to test using F distribution. This F test was introduced by the statistician called as R. A. Fisher. And there was one more was there, Snedecker. So here they too worked on this one, and this F distribution totally put forward by R. A. Fisher. Suppose here you want to test the hypothesis that the standard deviation of two population with unknown means are equal. That is, you want to test the hypothesis that standard deviation of two populations. So suppose sigma 1 and sigma 2 are the standard deviation of two populations with unknown means. Unknown means we don't know. Okay, so we need to test whether the standard deviation of two population with unknown means are equal or not. That is what we are going to test using F test. Okay, how the variance is changing and all. So sigma 1 equal to sigma 2 standard deviation, or you can write sigma 1 square equal to sigma 2 square, whether they are equal or whether they are big, small. So we need to check that. Okay, so for that purpose we used to take two samples of sizes n1 and n2, and these two samples of sizes from sizes n1 and n2 from normal population, and we calculate an unbiased estimate. Unbiased estimate, we use capital S. S1 square I will take, this is sigma xi minus say x1 bar of the first sample. So two samples we are taking from normal population, and we are calculating the estimate, unbiased estimate of the first one using the formula S1 square is sigma xi minus x bar the whole square divided by n1 minus 1. I hope you remember there is another formula to find the standard deviation or variance of sample, that is sigma xi minus x bar the whole square by n. This is here small s because the sample standard deviation or sample variance we use here. This is unbiased estimate only. Okay, and s1 square is this, and for the sample 2, suppose you calculate s2 square is a another some set of variables yi minus y bar the whole square divided by n2 minus 1. Okay, now after calculating this one, so what we have done, we take two samples of sizes n1 and n2 from two normal population, and we calculated the unbiased estimate of this s1 and s2, and then we calculate here f is equal to s1 square divided by s2 square, and here we assume s1 square is bigger than s2 square. Okay, and then this follows this follows an f distribution with degrees of freedom. We take nu 1 is n1 minus 1 for the numerator, nu 2 n2 minus 1 for the denominator. Okay, so here n1 and n2 are two samples from two normal population. We calculate their unbiased estimate using this formula. Then f equal to s1 square by s2 square follows f distribution with nu 1 is n1 minus 1 degrees of freedom and nu 2 is n2 minus 1 degrees of freedom. Now so as I told earlier, small s square is means variance, sample variance is summation of xi minus x bar the whole square upon n1. So from here you will get n1, say sample 1, I'm putting it as say s1. So n1 s1 square is summation xi minus x bar the whole square. Similarly, s2 square for sample 2, s2 square is summation yi minus y bar the whole square upon n2. This means n2 small s2 square is summation yi minus y bar the whole square. Now, when I put that value into this, I'm going to substitute that summation of xi minus x bar the whole square, this value means summation of xi minus x bar the whole square is n1 s1 square. So that value I'm putting here. Okay. So s1 square by s2 square, big s1 square by s2 square. S1 square was summation of, I'm writing it again, xi minus x bar the whole square by n1 minus 1 divided by s2 square was summation of yi minus y bar the whole square by n2 minus 1. This is equal to from here xi minus x bar the whole square is n1 s1 square. So it is n1 s1 square by n1 minus 1 upon this is n2 s2 square by n2 minus 1. This is what our f. Okay, so f is equal to, this is what we calculate. Then here, when we use this f equal to s1 square by f2 s2 square, we assume that this s1 square is greater than s2 square. Okay, if it is not like that, we have some other method to solve the question. Okay, now in short, now how to test this one? Now how procedure for testing the hypothesis. That sigma 1 square equal to sigma 2 square or not. Now I'll tell you how to check this, how to test this using F distribution. Okay, so two-tailed test means when the region of rejection is on both sides. So as I told earlier, in two-tailed test, if alpha is 10, 5%, you consider half of this alpha. Okay, then so two-tailed test, here we consider the statistic f is equal to s1 square by s2 square. Then if s1 square is greater than s2 square and level of significance is given as alpha, then we what we do here is we find f n2 sorry, fn1 minus 1 and n2 minus 1 alpha by 2. Means you calculate this first of all. We will calculate this value later. If s1 square is greater than s2 square and if LOS is alpha, then we find fn1 minus 1 n2 minus 1 at alpha by 2. Okay, so since it is 2 tail test, if alpha is given, you will take alpha by 2. Means 10% is given, then in the table you have to look for 0.05, means 5%. Okay, so you will find out this one. Then we find, so firstly you will find this one, then secondly we will find the reverse also, that is n2 minus 1 and n1 minus 1, means degree of freedom. Suppose it is 8, 10 here, second case you will find 10, 8. Okay, that also at alpha by 2. Now, if reciprocal of this one, then you find the reciprocal of this value, that is, then if 1 by fn2 minus 1, n1 minus 1 at alpha by 2 is less than f, this calculated, is less than this value, fn1 minus 1, n2 minus 1, alpha by 2. Means simply if saying calculated value, if it lies between these two values, then we accept the hypothesis, otherwise we reject the hypothesis. Okay, so while solving a question you will get it more well. Then now the other two cases I'll explain that in short. That is, so this is what I told just now, if h0 is sigma 1 square equal to sigma 2 square, so this is all the three test, I mean right tail, left tail and two tail test in a single page. So h0 sigma 1 square equal to sigma 2 square we want to check. Then alternate hypothesis, obviously sigma 1 square not equal to sigma 2 square. So f equal to large sample, means here suppose s1 square upon s2 square. Okay, degrees of freedom is this one. Then if it is two tail test, that is what I already explained here, two tail test, then what we do here, you calculate these two, 1 upon fn2 minus 1, n1 minus 1 at alpha by 2, and this value, if calculated value lies between that two values, then you accept h0. Now if the test is one tail means if h0 sigma 1 square greater than or equal to sigma 2 square, means right tailed test, then ha will be sigma 1 square less than sigma 2 square. In that case you need to calculate f is s2 square upon s1 square. Okay, so f is s2 square upon s1 square, and in that case what we do here we calculate, just you calculate f is equal to f of n2 minus 1, n1 minus 1, means degrees of freedom of this denominator, n2 minus 1, n1 minus 1 at alpha. Whatever alpha is given, that alpha, suppose 10% alpha is given, then here you will find the table value of f at 10%. Okay, so f alpha, and suppose that is equal to, I am giving another name, f alpha, then you find 1 upon f of alpha. So what we do, you calculate f equal to s2 square by s1 square as usual, then f of n2 minus 1, n1 minus 1 at alpha table value you will get. Okay, that table value I am just giving another name, f of alpha. Then find the reciprocal of, suppose I am getting here 2, then find the reciprocal of this. Reciprocal of 2 is 1 by 2. Now if the calculated value, means using this formula already you have calculated, if that calculated value is less than 1 upon f alpha, okay, 1 upon f alpha, then reject the hypothesis, otherwise accept the hypothesis. So f of f calculated value, if it is less than 1 by f of alpha, suppose calculated value I got as 1 by 4, and 1 by f alpha I got as 1 by 2. So here 1 by 4 is less than 1 by 2, So what we do? We reject the hypothesis. Okay. So that is one tail test means a right tail test. Now left tail or the other one, left tail test, that is H0 sigma 1 square is less than or equal to sigma 2 square. Alternate hypothesis is sigma 1 square greater than sigma 2 square. In that case, you calculate. So be careful when you use this. Okay. So F is equal to S1 square by S2 square. F is equal to S1 square by S2 square. Here it's so simple. Just you have to calculate this. You calculate this one. Then find the table value. Directly find the table value. Now if F calculated is less than F table value, accept H0. Okay. So the first case, what we do there, if it is two tail test, you have to find F value at alpha by 2 for both the degrees of freedom. Then find the reciprocal. If the calculated value lies between that two values, accept H0. Now if it is right tail, then F of N2 minus 1, N1 minus 1 we do and take the reciprocal. If calculated value is less than that value, then reject the hypothesis. Okay.